All right, time for some ice cream. Spence, did you eat all the ice cream again? Hello, filmmakers. Ash here, and welcome to Film It Yourself. Camera movement is one of the best filmmaking tools you can use to help make your audience feel like they are right there with the characters. And a whip pan is no exception. A pan is any time your camera moves to the left or right of the X axis, while a whip pan is essentially a much faster version of this. Because it's so fast, it tends to blur the image, which gives you as a filmmaker the opportunity to hide a cut. Whip pans can be effective in showing a few things. First up, it can help show motion of a character or object. Second, whip pans can help show your character's point of view, or POV for short, and make the viewer feel like they are right there with them. And finally, third, they can be used as a creative transition from scene to scene, like it's doing here. So, now that you know what a whip pan is, let's talk about some tips on how to achieve them. First up, as always with filmmaking, you want to make sure the whip pan is motivated. How does it help tell your story or convey an emotion? Is it helping to emphasize some sort of action? Second, if you're using the whip pan to show the motion of a character or an object, make sure you're moving the camera in the same direction the character or object is moving and stay consistent with that whip pan in both shots. So, for example, if you're tracking the motion of an object moving camera left to right, you want to whip pan to the right to match the object. Then, in the second shot, you'd continue the right whip pan to maintain the persistence of motion. In this example, we were trying to fake an axe throw. So, using this camera trick helped us make the audience feel like the axe was flying in from the camera left and embedding itself into our actor's head. When, in reality, it's actually an optical illusion, as the axe is already on the actor's head, but the persistence of motion helps sell the effect. Third, I'd recommend when doing a whip pan that you storyboard it out. Storyboarding your whip pan out can help you keep track of which direction to pan, which will help ensure the whip pan will work. Fourth, I also recommend that if it's possible, do a test shoot. Again, this can help you test the shot to make sure it's working. And finally, fifth, sound effects can really help sell your whip pan, either as a transition like this, or as a method to make a special effect more convincing, like this. So, now that you know how to pull it off, your camera moves will be the coolest in town as they ghost ride the whip all day long. And speaking of being cool, if you want to become part of the super cool FIY crew, you can by supporting me on Patreon for as low as $2 a month. There, you can get access to all of my videos early, download my filmmaking templates, and much more. You can find the link in the description. So, what are you waiting for? Like, seriously, don't wait for this video to be over. Go now! I'll wait. No?